Hey guys, what's up? It's good to be back. So as you might see, guys, this is definitely not my room. This is my little brother's room, and if memory serves you, this is where my Paludarium super tank is what I like to call it. And right now, it's Christmas. Merry Christmas, everyone. I'm redoing it because I got some supplies to redo it. I've been trying to do this for a while, so we're going to get to work right now. Also, forgive me. I just woke up.
All right, so the first thing we want to do is put them in holding tanks while I do a whole renovation. So let's do some introductions of the lizards and frogs. First, we have Oogie. He's one of our males. We got him in October 2018. Right here we have Charlotte, a female that we got in June 3rd, 2018. Tiana, the other female, June 3rd, 2018 again. The last one, we got the big guy, Naveen, one of my favorites, June 3rd, 2018. And we got our brown anole. We got him back in February, I want to say. This is the first time he's on camera, actually, because he always hides from people. Mrs. Kipling, we got her early January of 2019. Then we got our green anole, Liz. You can't really see her right now because of the cover, but you'll see her later in the video. You'll see her in a lot of different videos. Oh, the decor in the tank, ready to be cleaned at the sink. And we got a brand new brick of coconut fiber. So what you do with this, you soak it in water, and it expands into a lot of coconut fiber, which is the substrate of the tank. So right here we got a time lapse of it growing, and it's really, really cool. Soaked for the right amount of time, that's what it turns into. And I isolated the moss just so I can spread it out evenly throughout the tank afterwards, so I put them in little containers just so I have them handy. Let's start cleaning the decor. And now right here, after the brick has soaked for a while, this is what it is. This is the empty tank right now. I'm going to make some space for the new pool that I'm making. That'll make the whole thing look a lot more natural. I'm really excited for the final result. Now we're going to dump the new coconut fiber onto it. Cleaned out the filter, but now I'm letting all the other little gunks that I can't really get out by making it filter out just really clean water, so it's basically just cycling through. Now I have the new substrate covering the entire tank except for the part where the pool is. And there it is, set up with the old water decor, and now we're going to see how this looks. Now I'm putting some of the land decorations in. I'm going to put them near the water just so I have some vines going over it, because sometimes I like to drink from the filter, and I want that to happen without them, you know, like drowning. The lizards I'm talking about, the frogs will be fine. But I'm just doing that too. I have a log that goes under the ground that I'm going to use as like a cave for them. So it's going to be everything they really need. This is what it was looking like before. Not bad, not bad. But this is the final product. And I think it looks a lot better and a lot more natural. It all comes together a lot easier. No pieces of plastic standing out like that. I love it. I love it. I think it looks great. I always keep some water in there for the lizards to drink so they're not drinking possibly toxic water from the toads, but the toad water is for the most part not bad for them because it's often filtered and they're domestically breeded, so they don't have as much toxins. I put some worms in there for them to eat upon their return to the tank, so let's put them back in the tank. Alright, so right here, I don't know who I'm grabbing right now, but I'm going to put one of the toads back in the tank, and it looks like I got... that's Naveen! And there goes Naveen. Then, who are we going to get next? I think I'm getting Charlotte next in this next clip. And she almost gets away from me, so I struggle a bit with her. She's always been feisty on, but I really like Charlotte. She's one of my favorites. You'll see. And there she goes. Anyways, Tom goes in the tank. There's Mrs. Kipling in the back, so there she's back in the tank. Then we got Liz above her on the glass. There he is. Looking brown, as he normally does for some reason. There we go. There's Oogie. And right there, there's Tiana. Well, anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions about making your own paludarium like this, you can DM me. My Instagram is shep_the_herper. Leave your suggestions for new videos in the comments below. Subscribe to me if you want more. I do a lot of videos. Have a great day.